Hi, a quick update video about the Hewlett-Packard oscilloscope from the NATO. I did actually scrap it, and here is the CRT from it. So, do not take care of the clean shielding here. I did clean it, but it is actually still very dirty inside. So, we will find out the exact condition of the tube. So first, we have to be careful with this thing because there are quite sharp contacts here, like needles. So is it bad or is it not bad? First, here we have very serious wear marks. You can see it is brown inside. It is not normal, I believe. We have here what was apparently gaiters. And they are white like this, and look at this, really, really weird looking. So it means air did go inside the CRT. And surely enough, look at this. We have not one, but two cracks here on the neck. And this whole neck piece is actually quite loose and coming apart. If I pull a little bit harder, it will eventually come off. So, really not a happy CRT. We have some interesting information here. Sorry, I cannot put in the vertical direction because it is too long for my bench. We have an approved stamp from Hewlett-Packard with an inspector number and a lot of stamps actually, the quality assurance, not insurance. Apparently, back in the time, the quality was okay. And we have here the model number tag with its own serial number, quite a huge one. Hewlett-Packard, made in USA. And you can see the internal construction. So obviously, if air did go inside the tube, it is why the filament is blown, because it did burn. It must be located here at the back, the electron gun. All your acceleration parts here, and then here your deflection coils for horizontal and vertical deflections. Excuse me, not coils, plates, electrostatic plates. Everything is mounted on this glass rod you can see inside. And here you have your hand. Your accelerator piece, apparently, probably. Looks like we have some more stuff going in here. You can see here very fine wires connected from this contacts and going here through this tube further down in here. But I can see it goes no further than this part here. Of course, here your high voltage connection. And it is all your front, okay, and the broken back piece. So it is why it died, obviously. I have no idea of what I will do with this thing now. It will probably end in the recycling center because I cannot keep such stuff. It is really, really bad. But at least we know what happened to it. Maybe someone did do a bad thing to the back connector here and did break the glass. I do not know. Quite weird. Yes, I can see the crack line extends further down here. I can see here below the glass rod, actually. And the other one also. So yes, the neck is almost completely broken and coming off. Not far from coming off. So there was plenty of space for air to come through, and also I did just notice a crack here, which must be why it does not stay glued. So really, really a sad CRT, but at least now we know what happened to it, and I have peace of mind of having scrapped the oscilloscope. It is not a rare unit anyways, and I did retrieve a lot of useful parts as imperial screws from it. So, thanks for watching. Bye bye.